Welcome to our paper, Listening Human Behavior, 3D Human Pose Estimation with Acoustic Signal. In this work, we developed a new framework to map acoustic features into 3D human poses. First, let me explain the summary of our research. We used a setting with speakers and ambisonics microphone. This video shows the qualitative result. The first sequence shows a subject walking in an echoic chamber with mocap suit. In this frame, one of the previous work failed to predict leg positions. Our model utilized time-wise CNN, so it can successfully output smoother poses. The second sequence shows the same subject performing various poses in a classroom environment, putting on a plain clothes. It is proven that our proposed model is robust for noisy classroom environment and plain clothes settings as well. As this video shows, our method successfully predicts more stable poses than Zhang et al. Model. At this frame, both of previous work failed to predict T-pose, which is difficult to estimate due to a small area of reflection. In this slide, we will briefly explain some limitations of prior human pose estimation methods. The most famous and extensively researched method is RGB image-based models. These models have very good accuracy, as you can see the picture below. However, it tends to fail in dark environment or seen with occlusion. Also, taking photos or videos with cameras can lead to privacy issues. Recently, Wi-Fi or RF-based methods are also developed. They can successfully work in dark settings, but there are some restrictions in places with precision installments, such as airplane or hospitals. Lastly, the field most relevant to our research is acoustic signal-based models. However, the models that have been developed so far use invasive sensing or sound semantics, such as speech or sounds of musical instruments being played. These issues mentioned so far led us to undertake this research, 3D human pose estimation based on active and non-invasive acoustic sensing. This slide shows our technical contributions. For active acoustic sensing, we use two speakers and an ambisonics microphone. Then, we extract two acoustic features, logMAR spectrogram and intensity vector, based on received 4-channel signals. These features are fed into 2D downsampling and 1D timewise unit layers to output 12 pose sequences. For this part, we utilize subject discriminator module to make our features subject invariant by adversarial learning. From our next slide, we will explain each step in detail. The first point is about active acoustic sensing. Two speakers repeat TSP signals which increase their frequency linearly over time. This TSP signal is sometimes used for room impulse response measurement. So in this work, we try to capture human pose at every moment by repeating this signal. Also, we deployed an ambisonics microphone. Each acoustic signal is synchronized and exported as a B format that has 4 channels of signal representing a different microphone polar pattern. Our sensing system has two characteristics. Initially, because it is active sensing, our model doesn't use any sound semantics, such as speech or instruments, and can avoid privacy issues. Also, sounds are recorded in a non-invasive way, so subjects don't need to put on any special devices. The second point is acoustic feature extraction. We use MEL spectrogram and intensity vector. MEL spectrogram represents sound amplitude at each time frame and frequency beam in MEL scale. Intensity vector indicates acoustic energy direction of a sound wave. These two features are concatenated along channel axis, so the final input for our model has 7 channels in total. The last component of our framework is CNN part and subject discriminator module. Acoustic features are fed into 2D CNN layers to generate temporal consistency-aware acoustic features. Then, 1D timewise unit is used to output smoother and more stable poses. Here, we propose a subject discriminator module to decrease feature distributional shift among subjects. We use adversarial learning by preventing this discriminator from accurately predicting subjects. This table shows our quantitative result. As you can see, Our proposed method outperformed previous work in all the settings except PCK at 0.5 in a classroom and cross-subject setting. This slide shows the subject discriminator module effect. As you can see, our proposed method outperformed previous work which uses cross-entropy loss for adversarial learning. Figure shown below indicates our adversarial learning method successfully reduces feature gaps among three subjects, which leads to better generalization ability. In summary, we showed for the first time that it is possible to obtain human pods with active and non-invasive acoustic sensing. We propose a new framework to map acoustic signals into human pods with intensity vector, Mel spectrogram, and subject discriminator module. For more detail, please check out our paper and its project page where you can find our created dataset as well. Thank you for listening.